While traipsing through forgotten tunnels, the heroes had learned the true depth of deception their adversaries were capable of. Sunny and Godric's cold and calculated plans had obliterated the kingdom overnight. And so Amadeus, Pontius, and Zoya had found themselves stumbling in the dark, more lost than ever before. But now they were approaching the hills, leading them up to the Astral Observatory, and perhaps some direly needed assistance.
The Astral Observatory is somewhere up in these hills.
So there must be a road or a path somewhere that leads to it.
Oh, I wouldn't be too sure. They work magic after all. They don't need roads.
Seems like we've some climbing to do.
So, about these people up in the observatory. They're not like the wizards you're used to back at the old academy.
So, not snobs with delusions of grandeur. I like the sound of that.
No. More like, well, there are reasons why these three are all hidden away up here. It's lovely up here.
The first innkeeper of the Red Rose Inn, Uncle Tuvac, was an avid reader. His ghost visits the Red Rose to read all the books he didn't have time to read while still alive. Whenever a new volume is added to the old attic bookshelf, his footsteps can be heard the following night. Some guests claim to have seen him reading by the fire.
I wonder if old Uncle Tuvac has any valuable books up in the attic.
Thank you.
haunted burial grounds. Just the thing we needed.
No rest for the wicked, they say. So, are these wizards up in the observatory prisoners or something?
Not at all. I'm just saying that we should be careful.
What? We're going to see people that are even worse than Lady Sunny now?
Nothing like that. These three just aren't very popular. And they don't care for visitors.
Master Wizardess Wilhelmina of the Astral Academy. Dear esteemed colleague, we've run short of supplies at the observatory and no one is replying to our letters. Also, a bit curious is the fact that I conjured an image of our dear alma mater. In my vision, I saw nothing but a pile of sand cleaned very enthusiastically by an enchanted broom. Is everything quite all right?
Oh. Barbara said this.
One of our observing wizardesses.
Uncaught by the villains.
Such a shame we can't stay to enjoy the scenery.
Thank you.
The kingdom is in such a mess, even the dead don't stay dead.
That sign points to something magical.
You go and see what it's all about. Holler if you need us.
Have fun with your wizard quest.
Up on the mist-ridden forest paths, Amadeus discovered a mystical clearing.
Old wild mountain magic. What could possibly go wrong here? Levitation enchantment studies. There's no telling what kind of majestic contraptions I'll be able to conjure now.
Thank you.
Your brave wizard returns with a new spell.
Well done, Amadeus.
Any fancy crowns lying around?
Amadeus, let's hear more about these weasels.
Helga is an expert stargazer, hates people, loves the observatory. Then there's Barbara. She makes magic out of tea leaves and mirrors.
Oh, they don't sound that dangerous.
And poor Valerius turned his friend into stone, which then accidentally crumbled. Valerius has been on sick leave ever since.
Sounds like a fun bunch.
Thank you.
We're almost there. And no clockwork knights either. So we should be all good.
What happened to the fellow? That wizard friend of yours turned to stone.
Oh, they were just fooling around. Apparently, a good thump cancels the stone spell, but only if it comes early enough.
So he smashed his own friend to pieces. That's awful.
We're too late. The villains are already here.
They might have captured every last wizard already.
No, we're not giving up after coming all this way. Get ready.